In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you a pro Revit tip for families. So I'm going to be showing you how to set up a family type catalog. First, we're going to cover what are family types, and then how to use a family type catalog, and then I'm going to be showing you on an actual family how to set up family types and how to export a family type catalog. Let's go. Now, if you want to become a Revit expert, but also want to make that learning journey as quick and easy as possible, I would like to ask you to check out BalkanArchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And that's where you can find all of my Revit courses as well as other very useful content for Revit users. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. First, let's answer the question, what are family types? Well, here, as you can see, I have a really good example of one family with multiple types. So here, this desk is one family, and then we have placed three instances of that family, and each one is a different type. So what this basically means is that this family, if I expand the properties panel drop menu, you can see that here we have the AD table, this is the name of this family, and then here we have five types of that family. So basically this family comes with five different presets for different dimensions. So now if we decide to place one more table, we can place it here, and at any point we can select it, and then we can make it a different size or a different type. So that's basically how family types work. Now let's talk about what is a family type catalog. So I'm sure you have seen this, and I'm just going to drag over this folder. It's basically when you have a Revit family and then you have this additional text file in the same location. When you have this family type catalog, when you load in this family, and I'm just going to go here to component, load family, find the family on your computer, and you're going to notice that here it's not going to display that family type catalog. It's only because it's displaying just the Revit files. But as long as it's there, you're going to get the type catalog functionality. And that is, when I hit open, it's not going to just open up this family, it's going to first open up the specify types dialog, and it looks like this. So instead of loading in all of these types in the interest of saving space on my project and making the file size smaller, I can only select the types that I want. Now I can select one of them, or I can hold the control key and then select multiple types. Or if you're loading in a wider selection, you can just select one, hold the shift key, and then select at the bottom. So it's going to select all of those in between. So now if I just select these three and hit OK, it's going to load in this family. And then if I open up the properties, you're going to notice that in this case, instead of five, we only have three types for this family. So we have saved some space without loading in the families that we don't need. One more thing that you also want to keep in mind when it comes to type catalogs, you might get a lot of types. So here you can see we have this family, it's a window family that has really a lot of types. So in those cases, you can always use the filters here. So for example, for the rough height of the window, I can go and I can specify here, as you can see, even though we have many types, we only have two heights. So I can just say I want to specify this, and then I can just go along this menu. You can use the bottom scroll, and then you can find the rough widths that we have, and then I can say, okay, I only want this one. So that's going to narrow my search down quite a bit, and then I can pick out the ones that I want according to the rest of the parameters. So these filters are something that you want to use if you have a very large type catalog. Also, something really important that you want to keep in mind when it comes to type catalogs is that even though the type catalog is at the same location where the family is, if you don't load that family in like I've shown you before, if you just drag it over from folder to computer, which is something I like to do often, well, you don't get that type catalog. In this case, it did load in all of the types that I wanted, but it didn't show me the type catalog, so I didn't get the chance to remove the types that I didn't want. So if you're dragging over from folder to Revit, you're not going to get that type catalog, and that's just something to keep in mind. Now we're going to be jumping into the family editor, and I'm going to be showing you how to set up family types and then how to export a family type catalog. So here we have that same table family, And if I open up the reference level here, you can see that it is set up as a parametric family. Here we have those parameters already set up. So now if I go back to the 3D view, I want to now set up our family types. So what you need to do is you need to go here to the properties panel. So it's on the create tab and find the family types button. It's going to open up family types, and here you can see a list of all of your parameters. And then here we have the type name on top. Now this might be completely grayed out if you're starting with a fresh family that haven't set up types before. Here in this case I have set up some types and I have now deleted them, so it only says table here. So now to create a new family type, what you want to do is you want to come here to this new type button, you want to click, and now it's time to name our type. Now, I like to name types according to dimensions for a lot of families. So in this case, I'm just going to call this one table, and then I'm going to go with the length and width dimensions. So this will be table 60 by 80 centimeters. Okay, so once I have created this name, I can click OK. And now, as you can see, we have two types, and now we can toggle between those. And for this type, I'm just going to leave the parameters as is. Okay, so now this type is pretty much set up. So now let's create a new one. So for the next one, I'm just going to go here to new type. I'm going to call this one again table. But now it's going to be, instead of 60 by 80, it's going to be 80 by 120 centimeters. Now I'm going to click OK, and then I'm going to change the dimensions. So here you go to the table length. So the length is going to be 80, and then the width is going to be 120. Now, once we have set these dimensions up, I like to hit apply, and then you're going to see the change in the family. So you can see that everything is working correctly. And now once you have done this, when you switch back to your table 60 by 80, keep track of the values here. See how they now change. And if I hit apply, the table is going to change its size as well. So we can change now the or toggle through the types of this family. Now, if you want to change a type, an existing type, so for example, let's change this one. I want to create a new one. So what I'll do here is then I'm just going to go to rename type, and then I can say, okay, this is going to be table. Let's go 90 by 90. And then click OK. Now I have just renamed this type, and now I can just change the length and the width parameters to 90 centimeters. Hit apply to confirm that change, as well as see the change in the 3D view here. And now if we toggle in between those, you can see we now have all of these types that we have created. Now I'm just going to click OK to close this menu up, and now it's time to export our family types, or the family type catalog. Now to export the family type catalog, you need to go here to File, go to Export, and it's conveniently placed here, Family Types. You just click on that, and you just need to define where you want to save it. So I'm going to save it here in the same folder where the family is, and I'm going to give it the same name as the family, and it just gives it the regular .txt file extension because this is a text file. Now we just hit save and we're done. We now have a family type catalog for this table. Now to test this out, I'm just going to start a new project. Go to Insert, then go to Load Family, find that family, click to select and hit Open, and now we have that new family types catalog, and here you can see all three types which we have created, and now we can load all of them, or we can load just some of them, and our family type catalog is working. And that's going to conclude today's tutorial. Thank you for watching, and if you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, like this family file that we have here, but also the rest of my Revit files, you can find all of that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.